Hey guys, welcome to another video. Today I'll be playing modded Terraria for the first time. I'll be doing a blind playthrough of Calamity because I thought it would be fun since I've only been playing vanilla Terraria for, you know, the entire time I've had Terraria. Right off the bat, it was time to create my character, the one who will be known across the lands for his might. Now, it was time to create the world, and since mama didn't raise no pussy, we were going expert mode. And corruption, of course, for the scarf. And with that, a respectable name for my world. Now, it was finally time to load up our world. Okay, let's load up our world again. Let's make a world now. Fourth time's charm. Let's try this one more time.
Woo! Yeah, baby! That's what I've been waiting for. That's what it's all about. Woo!
Finally, the world had loaded up. Then I opened this bag that gave me a bunch of stuff, including different modes that would make the game harder. But I was not gonna mess with that. Next, I decided to go exploring and finding new loot so I could figure out what happens in this modded world. On the way, I decided to mine as much lead as I could so I could make lead armor and weapons and tools. I also got my first life crystal. And damn, you lose breath and water really quickly. Then, I found myself another life crystal. And I got this ice boomerang, which is a really good early game weapon to have that's OP. Then, I saw this really weird looking creature, and died to a poison dart. Next, I looked at this boss guide, which would help me progress by telling me what boss I have to fight next. Damn, that rhymed. I clicked on the blind playthrough mode because this was my first time playing Calamity, but instead it just locked all the bosses, so I couldn't see how to spawn them. Which kinda sucks. So I decided to reload the mod to see if I could change the blind playthrough mode. But it didn't work at all, so all I could do was just put my stuff in a chest and make a new account, I guess. And now I could finally see all of the bosses and how to spawn them, and when to spawn them in the progression. After that, I decided to start making the basic Terraria house, or room I guess, and put the basic tools like the furnace and anvil inside of it. Then I went to some living trees that were next to my house and decided to explore them. Then I died to the strongest enemy in all of Terraria, the boulder. Then I found this pyramid inside of the desert that I could go and explore. After I got inside of the pyramid, I found this sandstormer bottle. Then this weird creature thing appeared that made a circle around itself, so I decided to kill it. I also forgot that I had a sandstorm in a bottle and decided to build my way up with a platform, which was kind of stupid. And that's when I lost half of my footage. I don't know why, but I just stopped recording. So everything I did for like 2 hours just went into the void until I realized that it wasn't recording. So here is me after I defeated the Desert Scourge and Eye of Cthulhu. Yeah, I mean, all that happened was that I got a lot of new weapons and items, and I built up my house. A couple more stories, I would say. So I decided to fight the Desert Scourge with the same items I had when I first defeated it, so here is the footage. So yeah, this boss was actually really easy, way easier than I thought it would be. Especially since I'm in expert mode. Next, I decided to dig straight down until I would run into one of those glowing mushroom biomes that would allow me to fight this Crabulon crab thing, which was the next boss I needed to fight. So here's a time lapse of me just basically mining and digging.
Oh my god, bro.
Oh, hell no, man. What the fuck, man? Get your ass up.
And since it was already nighttime, here's me fighting the Eye of Cthulhu with the same equipment I had before. So, here you go. There we go, I killed the Eye of Cthulhu once again. And many times more. This one just left though because it was afraid of me and my martial prowess, my absolute technique. Now it was time to just keep digging until I found the glowing mushroom biome. And not fall for a trap again. We were finally at the glowing mushroom biome after like an hour of mining. But for now, I kept digging until I would reach the underworld because might as well get it out of the way, then, you know, do it later. Oh yeah, also, I just realized we're actually at max health already. And there we go, we were finally in hell. Next, I went back home so I could create the Spectre boots, which I will need to fly and run fast. Then, I went back to the desert so I could create the Krabulon boss spawn item, so I could go fight him in the glowing mushroom biome. Now I could finally fight Krabulon, but first I decided to cut up the lava with stone blocks so I wouldn't fall in and die. But first, since I had no idea how Krabulon functioned, I decided to do a test fight before making an arena to see if I even needed an arena. I mean, I didn't do too bad because it was the first time I ever fought it, but I would definitely need an arena to fight it so I could jump up and down and avoid it. You only needed 1 foot for the arena since it was a big boss and I could just jump up and down instead of like a flying boss that I would avoid. And now it's time to fight him again. I actually killed it the second try, with only a little bit of health left. Sadly though, it only dropped two of its weapons, the gun and this fungal clump thing that would fight for me and heal me. So I decided it would be better to just fight it again. So, I killed it again, but this time it only dropped the mage weapon, which kinda sucked because it was only like an AoE around you weapon, which I didn't really need, so all I could do was just fight it again. But this time it actually dropped everything that it had, so I could finally see if there's anything useful that I would need. turns out he actually dropped wings, which I didn't know was possible in pre-hard mode, but I guess it is. So, I mean, pre-hard mode wings, that's really OP. No fall damage and, like, high flight time. And the flight time was actually really good considering that was a pre-hard mode wing, and it was much better than the fledgling wings. Then I decided to see what boss I had to fight next, and I put my eyes on the Eater of Worlds since all the ones that came before that were like event bosses and like events that need to happen. But I didn't have time to wait for that, so I went straight to trying to fight the Eater of Worlds. And then I realized that I forgot to get bombs. And then I headed back to Corruption. And then I realized I forgot to get bombs once again. Now it was finally time to break those stupid shadow orbs. And there we go, time to fight the Eater of Worlds. Damn, that fight was so easy. I didn't even, like, break a sweat. Then, after making some shadow armor, I decided to make a hell bridge across hell so that I wouldn't have to do it later when I have to fight Wall of Flesh. After dying to a demon, I checked to see what boss I have to fight next. It was this hive mind thing, which I assumed was going to be located in the Corruption. Next, I decided to start blowing up hell for some hellstone, which I needed for the next armor I would need, which provides me with fire resistance and temporary lava resistance. And finally, I had plenty of hellstone to make some armor and tools with. But then I realized I also need obsidian with the hellstone to make the bars. Now I had enough obsidian to make a bunch of hellstone bars, which let me make the armor, tools, and weapons with the hellstone bars. And god damn, the fiery greatsword was huge, way bigger than I remembered it to be. And turns out I did not have enough obsidian, so I just went back down to get more obsidian. Now finally, I had a full set of molten armor, which would help me a lot with bosses that I fight because it gave me more melee damage and melee speed. Next, I decided to fight both the Death's Scourge and Iacrithul at the same time to test out the fiery greatsword that I just made and get a lot of money with. Even though I fought them so many times, I barely lost any health, and it was just so easy. This fire greatsword really puts in the work. Now it was finally time to fight the Hivecyst. After some research on it, I realized it was a little thing you have to find on the ground, and if you broke it, it would spawn in the boss. It was this little tiny thing right here that I have to break, so I got my fiery greatsword and just broke it. At first it was actually pretty easy, all I did was just stay on the ground while I hit it, but then it started flying around me, kinda like how the Bane of Cthulhu works in its second phase. And boom, first try, another boss of Calamity was down again. But sadly, the Hivecyst didn't really drop anything good, and I didn't have the time to fight it again, so I just moved on. The next boss, called the Perforcyst, had the same name as the Hivecyst, so I just assumed that it was like the crimson version of it, because it was just red instead of, you know, blue or purple. So for the next boss, since I'm way too lazy to fight the Queen Bee, it was finally time for the Skeletron so I could unlock the dungeon. But first, I decided to add some more rooms to my tower, or house, if you could even call it that. And there we go, there are four more new rooms to my tower, or house. Next, I started running around while looking at the recipe browser so I could find what sword or weapon I should make next. Then I stumbled upon this sword called the Biome Blade, which needed this bar called the Airlight Bar, so it was time to now go mining for Airlight Ore. But first, I needed to see what this Airlight Ore even looked like, so I had to go around searching for ores that looked different from the vanilla ones. Then I stumbled upon this greenish looking moss looking ore. And it turns out I was right, it was actually Airlight Ore, so all I had to do now was run around this cave system, mining, and trying to find this green looking mossy looking ore. And after a lot of unsuccessfulness of finding it, I decided I had enough and I could just go home and make some new stuff. But first, I needed to make a sky mill. The armor wasn't really that much better because it didn't provide fire resistance, so in the end all I ended up making was the weapon. And there we have it, the Biome Blade. Now, the ability on it was that I had to go around to different biomes, and if I hold right click on the ground, it'll get like the ability of that biome, and it can store up to two abilities at a time. So like, for example, the snow biome will give a different ability than the grass or plains biome. The grass ability gives this like little sword shootout that kind of had like the same effect as the Terra Blade, but much shorter, and less damage of course. The snow ability gives this 3-strike combo with 2 shorter strikes and 1 long stretched out strike at the end. Before I tested out the other stuff, I decided to make the Skeletron arena that I needed to fight Skeletron first, so that I could get it out of the way. And there we go. The beach ability gave this long stretched out whip that did massive damage but had slow speed, and if you hit it on a tile, it would pull you towards that tile. The beach ability, aka my favorite ability, is this 4 swords that spin around on a handle and progressively get bigger the more you hit an enemy, as I show on this hive cyst. It's also super quick and it deals massive amounts of damage. I killed the hive cyst way easily and way more quickly than last time. Next, all I had to do was just wait for nighttime so that I could spawn in Skeletron and fight him. Oh yeah, also, this desert ability lets you bounce off of walls. It was finally time to fight Skeletron and open the dungeon up. And damn, this fight was way easier than I imagined it to be. Even while I'm editing, it still looks so easy. The next boss was actually Deerclops, which I fought, won, and lost the footage somehow. So here's me fighting again with relatively the same items I had before. And there we go, I killed him once again. He didn't really drop anything good, except for this mass that spawns in hands to fight for me, but they barely did any damage, so it was time to move on to the next boss. It was time for the next boss, called the Slime God, which sounded really cool and strong, which made me wonder why it came before the Slime Queen. The boss was these two big slimes that would get smaller and multiplied when you got them low. And the first time I fought it, I died, so I went back and fought it again. But this time, revenge, hatred, and rage was filled into the eyes of Ball Eater Jr. And when it got low, it spawned in this little orb that flew around me and shot me with these crystals. But it was no match for Ball Eater Jr. Sadly, all I dropped were some mage items, and for this account, I was gonna go with more of a melee build, so in the end, it didn't really help me out. Now, it was time to go down to the dungeon and find the Murasama so that I could make the true Knight's Edge. And there we go, I finally found it after what felt like an hour. Then I made more rooms to my tower so that the NPCs like the Goblin Tinker, which would be really useful for reforging, could move in. And there we go, now we have the Knight's Edge, which wasn't really better than the Biome Blade, but it would come in really handy after we get into hard mode for a new weapon. And with everything ready, my weapon, my armor, and the Hellbridge, it was finally time to fight the Wall of Flesh and break into hard mode so I could fight new bosses and get new weapons and armor. And it spawned on the wrong side of the map. And I died, so I fought it again. And it spawned on the wrong side of the map again. At being full health in like 0.5 seconds, it insta-killed me. I also found this really cool weapon called the Old Lord's Oath Sword. That rhymes. And if you charge it up, you can do this like cool dash move. But it didn't really deal any significant damage, so I decided the only time I would use it is when I would have to evade a boss move. And he still spawned on the opposite side of the map. I kinda feel bad for the god at this point. Imagine how many times I've had to kill him. And now we sacrifice another noble guide for the cause of Ball Eater Jr. The tactic that I had to use when my potion was on cooldown and I was low on health was to run away and find some pots so that there was a chance in them that there was a heart that could heal me. Thank you. And there we go, we were finally into hard mode. All those guide sacrifices were not in vain. Thank you everyone for watching. This video took a lot out of me because it was countless hours of footage that I had to cut down and edit. And so if you enjoyed it, please make sure to hit the subscribe button. It would help me out a ton. And don't worry, the second part where I explore hard mode Calamity will be out soon. So I'll see you guys later.